got a Chromebook here, good keyboard, missing keys. I've got a bad keyboard that's also become a parts donor. So we're going to transplant keys from there over to here. Take the E key here. So what I want to do is I kind of want to lift up a little bit, don't really pry. And under here, you can see, we want to take this in on the top side of it because we don't want to pull, we want to pull the key off, not the scissors. So we'll pull that up like that. So now we have this off, it's clean, there's the key, put it off to the side. Now the easiest way for me, there's four little pegs. I usually take off the right side, bend it to the right. But you don't want to puncture the, any membrane or anything down below. So we're going to push that off to the side like that. Now this should lift up carefully. Alright, so there's the scissors. I'm going to push this off to the side. Okay. So over here, we're going to replace the E. So I'm going to slide this out just a little bit. The little mounting point. And again, careful not to puncture any membrane. I'm going to hook the top side up first. Then the bottom left in and the right side. So this slides in and I straighten the tab out. And then the E key snaps in evenly. So right there, and then that's it. So let's do another one. So this up, I'm going to use my other hand to just kind of hold it up. Okay, now the top part of this, I want to get it under there. So it's a small screwdriver, flat tip or something similar. I want to hold that down while I pull the key up because I don't want to separate the lift. There we go. You see there's this little peg here. Slide that out to the side and slide it out of its bracket so this whole thing slides over and then out. Go back over here and I'm going to set it in, put the bottom right in, and I'm going to pull that little peg out to the right. Careful not to damage the membrane and then push it back. Push the key on top. So, that's about all there is to it. It's not hard, but it can be hard. I used to do them the hard way. I'd never bent the pegs. Getting them off and the scissors would come apart. You don't want to break the little pegs on the end. Because if you break them off, obviously they won't function or the key won't sit on right or they'll press down weird and they'll kind of want to come up on the other corner. So, not super exciting, but a nice little tip I wish I knew 10 years ago. So, thanks for watching. Feel free to leave a comment if you have one. Press like if you like it. Subscribe if you want to see more. Dislike if you don't like it. Thanks for watching.